Hi, scientist. My name is Mustafa Ali, a brand new scientist buddy. So our for today's unit is Unit 4, How Do Plants and Animals Grow, Week 2 slash Lesson 2, which is Plants and Animal Life Cycles. So just in case you don't remember me, since I'm pretty new, my name is Mustafa Ali once again. I am a third-year student studying genetics, cell biology, and development. Hopefully pre-med and a future doctor. My pronouns are he, him, and his. And this is just a picture of me in the tallest building called Burj Khalifa, which is in Dubai. It has a nice background, as you can see, very tall buildings and a river. In the bottom is just a picture of what I enjoy, my passion, which is basketball. And these are my two favorite players, Stephen Curry and Kyrie Irving. So let's talk about our first discussion today. If you remember last time, we covered who is a scientist, and we determined that a scientist are people from different backgrounds, religion, and culture who have unique abilities due to their background, and they're all valued and have the ability to become a scientist. However, for today, we're covering what does a scientist actually do? Well, there's a lot of different scientists and they all study different topics. So I have a few examples right here. Let's cover the first one, which is a rocket science. So those who study rockets, and then we have a food scientist, those who study foods and try to come up with different ingredients, measurements. For example, like the pop that if you drink soda, it has different types of ingredients. Those are food scientists determines in order to taste very good. And then a lab scientist, as an example, those who study diseases and try to make a cure. For example, there's a lot of lab scientists right now studying the coronavirus and trying to figure a vaccine for it. So that's considered a lab scientist. And then a paleontologist, it's a hard word. Sometimes I even have a hard time saying it. A paleontologist. It's just a it means a scientist who studies fossils. So back in history, there were dinosaurs. So those who dig up the ground and dirt and try to figure out what fossil belongs to which animal by studying its history is considered a paleontologist. And then the last but not least, a marine scientist is those who study marine animals. So those who study animals that are found in the ocean and they just observe them. And I actually have a few pictures on the next slide. So for example, on the top left corner, this is a various scientists working on different parts of the rocket, building this so then it goes to space and we're able to observe different planets such as Mars. The right is a food scientist. As you can see, our famous soda brand, Coca-Cola, Fanta, and then these are all just different ingredients, and it just shows how she's measuring it in order to come with the final product, which is the Coca-Cola product. In the bottom left one is a marine biologist. As you can see, they're in scuba diving, which is actually a pretty fun activity to do. Hopefully, you have a chance in the future. So, as you can see, he has his notepad. You might be wondering how in the world are they writing in the middle of the water, but it's more of a computer notepad. So they're just taking observations, which is just basically looking at the animal and its habitat. And habitat is just a word for where an animal lives. So as you can see, it's studying this fish, and then these are coral reefs. So these types of fishes live in the coral reefs. So then a marine biologist scientist is just observing that fish. And then the bottom right corner is a paleontologist. As you can see, it's a scientist with a huge fossil. As you can see, this might be, they don't know what it is, you know? So it's just a huge fossil this doesn't seem like an animal that's living right now. So they bring it to a different site. They test it for how old it is by having different clues, look at the holes, how and trying to figure out where the other different pieces are. So, have you ever been to a museum? You see those huge dinosaurs. So those are all parts of a skeleton within the body, and a paleontologist found that in different parts of the world, and they just create a little image for us to understand how a dinosaur looked in history. So the main topic is that a scientist is a very broad term, which means that there's many different types of scientists. Just because you're a scientist doesn't mean you're always going to be in a lab. You're always going to be in different types of environments. As you can see, sometimes you're in the ocean, sometimes you're in a lab, sometimes you're outside in the desert, sometimes you might even be in the space. You know, when you go to a rocket, you're in space, and maybe you might be in Mars. You need to fix your rocket to come back down to Earth. So if you want to become a scientist, just know there's a lot of different other fields that we didn't cover. So hopefully that makes all sense. So let's move on to our second topic for today. So as you remember, if you remember last week, we talked about how plants are and animals are different and how are they alike. So last time we had a key point by asking ourselves, what major difference do you notice and how? And we used a checklist. So as an example right here, we have plants in the bottom left corner. And then on the right, we have a fish called a zebrafish. So on the left, let's see how these two, a plant and an animal, is different. So we'll check with the bottom checklist. Does it have eyes? Yes or no? So a plant will not have eyes, so that'll be no. Whereas a zebrafish does in fact have eye. We can only see one part of the eye, but then the other eye on the other side. So does it have a stem? Yes or no? A plant would indeed have a stem. However, a zebrafish will not have a stem. So as you can see, there's two major differences. One has eyes, one doesn't. One has a stem and one doesn't. So that's what we covered last week. However, now we're trying to understand what is the similarities and how are plants and animals alike. So our key point right here in the top right corner is we have to ask ourselves, what similarities are there between plants and animals? Well, do they just appear large out of nowhere, or do they, what do you think? Do they just come out looking like that and just look, and being a plant that tall and a fish this developed, this grown, or do they start from an initial place? Like, imagine yourself, did you just come into this world as a second grader, or did you first be, it was a baby, and then you became a second, a preschool, kindergarten, first grade, and now a second grader? So they just don't appear large. However, they appeared very small, and then with time they grew. And that's actually what we're going to cover for the rest of this presentation. So in our next slide, I'm providing an example of a life cycle of a zebrafish. We'll go over the main topics for this part, so don't be afraid by all these pictures. So as you can see right here is where they usually start at. It's called an embryo, which is so when two zebrafishes mate and they have eggs, it becomes an embryo, which is just a fancy term of a particular type of development where a zebrafish is getting their accumulating cells. As you know, humans and everything has cells. And once we have a lot of cells, we become a particular person or plant or animal. So this is just an egg, basically. So as you can see, the inner part is actually like the inner zebrafish that has not yet developed. And the outer layer right here is in fact just the outer covering to protect it from its outer environment. So as you can see in the next panels, let me just do a different color, pink right here. So as you can see right here, it starts to become a little bit different. And then right here has two cells. And then right here has four cells. And then right here it has eight cells. It might look like four cells, but then there's another pair on the other side. And then as we go to the right, it just keeps on going to more cells. And the most important part is the one we see the biggest difference, which is right here at panel D. Okay, so now just look at panel, look at this, the red marker and the pink marker. As you can see right now, we have an outer laying. We have a little object right now that's covering the inner part. And that's actually the zebrafish baby developing, as you can see. And then let me use a different color. Let's do blue. So as you can see right here, the blue marker, blue circle right here. So now you have the little zebrafish's head, its body, and its tail developing. And then let's use a different color, green. And now when you look at panel F, green, you see a little yolk, which could be technically considered as a stomach. And then we have its tail, and then we have its body, and then we have its head. So as you can see, it started from an embryo, which is like an egg-like structure where it's developing and growing. And then it became into a structure-like animal. And then later on, as time went by, it became a full zebrafish. And this is still considered a baby. And then later on, let's go back to us. So as now with time, this little small little baby zebrafish becomes a full-on fish. So as you can see, there's a life cycle. It just didn't appear as a huge fish out of nowhere. It was first a baby, and then with time it grew and grew, and then it became a, this is a 3-day post-fertilization, which just means 3 days after being born, and then with time became a full-on fish. So let's see an example of a plant. So with a plant, so as a plant, it's a little bit more different because we start with a seed. Let's get our marker out. Let's get red. So we start with the seed. And as you know, in order for a plant to grow, we need the sun, which is right here with this nice fancy glasses. And then we need water. And then with the water, it starts creating a roots in the grass. And then later on, it starts creating a stem. As you see, one of our checklists was, does it have a stem or not? So as you can see right here, my red marker, it has a stem. And then with time, it becomes larger. And then later on, it becomes an entire flower. So as you can see, it did not just start with us as a flower. It was first a seed. And then with time, it grew and grew and became larger to a plant. So let's clear all these drawings. We actually have an interesting video made by one of our scientist buddy named Haley. And then there's a link right here. Let's just go over it real quick. However, I'll provide this with the presentation. So it's an 11-minute video. So just take your time, watch it. It's very interesting, but I'll give you a brief overview. So at first, she introduces herself.
Hi, friends. Welcome to my lab. Like many of you, I've been working from home.
So this is just a microscope that allows us to see stuff, very small things, into a bigger view. So let's just skip a little bit. Yes, so this is the embryo. So this is where it's beginning to develop. And the inside part is the zebrafish itself. And the outside part circled is just a course called a chorion. So it allows it protects the zebrafish from the environment, like bacteria, external environments. It's like a little a shell, basically, like an egg. So imagine an egg, right? The white egg is a shell. That's what can be considered the circle part. And the inside could be the yolk, can be the inner part right here where the zebrafish is developing.
Looks like, see a little bit different on the left side, what turns into the fish. So, right here, so that's what we saw on day zero, tuned for chorion.
So right here, look at this. Very interesting. So you see the
zebrafish? Here's another one, just a little bit.
So you see with his eyes now, its stomach-like structure, its body, tail, and it's a shell, and it's just growing. So let's move on.
A dark speckle that you see, that's the pigment spots.
So yeah, just watch this video to this entire video, and it's very interesting. We also have another video prepared for y'all, which is a time lapse of a planet life cycle. So as you can see, this is a seed. As you can see, the roots are growing. It's growing. There's a stem that we're talking about, the leaves. This is day 15, so it takes a long time to grow. That's another observation. These are all roots. So yeah, just watch this video all over, the entire thing, and just see how something starts very small and grows very big. So, as a closing remarks, so to recap, so both plants and animals start small, and with time they become larger as they grow. Hopefully that was seen in this presentation. Next week we'll discuss what living things need to survive and to start talking about our experiment. In fact, we talked about one aspect of what living things need to survive in back to our plants example, where I said they need water and sun in order to grow from seed to a plant to a flower. But we'll go into more details next week. As always, I'll be sending out a new video each week to your classroom, and feel free to be in contact if any questions arise. My email is ilimu135@gmail.com, or ask your teacher on other ways to communicate with me. Hopefully everything makes sense. If not, just ask me any questions and I'll be happy to reply. Thank you for tuning in today to this presentation. Have a good day.